Welcome. Today we're going to take a look at the procedures for the failure of one or both of the flight management computers. We're about to depart on runway 26 left at the Hartsfield-Jackson Atlanta International Airport in Atlanta, Georgia. Let's get airborne and learn about the indications of an FMC failure and what the procedures for failure are. One thing to notice, on each navigational display, it shows which FMC is providing the data for the display. Here it indicates the left FMC is providing the data, while on the first officer's side it indicates the right FMC. This will help determine which FMC has an issue shortly. A VTK flag has appeared on the navigation display. Let's follow procedure.
My aircraft.
Control while steering flags for both pitch and roll have appeared at the top of the PFD. And now a map flag on the navigation display. The autopilot disengage light is flashing amber as we've reverted to control while steering, and the FMC alert light is also illuminated. On the captain's navigational display, FMCL has disappeared, while FMCR can still be seen on the first officer's display. The issue is with the left FMC.
FMC fail checklist.
After checking the QRC, where applicable, the pilot monitoring looks for the checklist in the quick reference handbook, referred to as the QRH. The checklist includes a picture showing the FMC alert light. This helps ensure the correct checklist is used.
FMC fail checklist. Condition: dual FMC failure. Loss of FMC data on both CDUs. Loss of FMC data on the captain's and first officer's navigation display map modes. No, I still have map mode. Left FMC failure. Loss of FMC data on both CDUs. Loss of FMC data on the captain's navigation display map mode. Right FMC failure. Illumination of the FMC message light. Loss of FMC data on the first officer's navigation display map mode. No, I still have map mode. Objective: to restore dual FMC operation, configure for single FMC operation or resume conventional navigation. Do you agree this is the correct checklist?
I agree.
Step 1. Choose 1. Only the left or right FMC has failed. That's true. Go to step 2. Step 2. FMC source select switch, both on L or both on R. Selecting the operating FMC. Switching to both on the right FMC.
Got my FMC back, selecting VNAV and LNAV.
Step 3. Dual FMC op restored message appears. It didn't. Dual FMC op restored message does not appear. It didn't. End of FMC fail checklist.
So, pretty simple, the left FMC is now getting data from the right FMC. Note on the captain's PFD, FMCR is now displayed. The aircraft is now operating on a single FMC. Let's try that again, and this time fail the right FMC. This time we get a message, single FMC operation, and the VTK, for vertical track, appears on the first officer's navigation display. The autopilot remains on the left side and maintains LNAV and VNAV. This time, the conditions for a right FMC failure are met. We have an FMC message light, loss of FMC data on the first officer's navigation display map mode, and single FMC operation scratchpad message. The checklist directs to switch the FMC select switch, this time to both on L, the operating FMC. The dual FMC op restored message did not appear, so the FMC fail checklist is once again complete. One last scenario, what happens when both FMCs fail?
My aircraft. FMC fail checklist.
This time, the conditions for dual FMC failure are met. We have a loss of FMC data on both CDUs and loss of FMC data on both navigation displays map modes. We have dual FMC failure, so step 1 directs us to step 4. Step 4 states to resume conventional navigation. Without an operating FMC, LNAV and VNAV are not available. Step 5 states to verify position relative to terrain using conventional navigation, with a note that EGPWS may use inaccurate GPS position data or an inappropriate value of RNP. This could result in a VSD terrain display that is incorrectly positioned relative to the airplane track. Lasting, we'll have to use the speed reference selector to set the current gross weight and reference airspeed bugs. And use the N1 set selector to set the N1 bugs. That completes the FMC fail checklist for a dual FMC failure. That wraps up our look at the non-normal procedure for both a single and dual FMC failure. Please click like if you enjoyed, and please subscribe to learn of our future videos. Thank you.